everyone, so I'm here today to film my Finish 5 by November 5th finale. So this was a collaboration project that I did with a few different project planners here on YouTube. It was started by Lorraine, and as usual I will link all of their channels down below in case you haven't heard of them and want to go and check them out. But we all decided that we were going to try and read 5 books by the 5th of November. We started the challenge back, I believe, in September, and we had until the 5th of November, or Bonfire Night in the UK, to read 5 books. Because I read a lot of books anyway, I decided that I was going to try and challenge myself even more by making it 5 books over 500 pages. And now, while I did not completely complete the challenge, I do think I was really successful. So first, I'll run through the books that I finished prior to this finale. The first book that I read was The Journals of Sylvia Plath, 1950-1962, edited by Karen V. Kukil. This is basically a complete collection of all of Sylvia Plath's journals and excerpts between 1950 and 1962. It doesn't go all the way up until her death, because a lot of those journals are either missing or were destroyed by Ted Hughes, but as you can see, it's a bit of a mammoth, and it was a lot of reading. It was a pretty dense book, and it did take me a really long time. If my memory serves, I hadn't completed this by the first update. It took until the second update for me to complete it, but overall, I really loved it. I found it quite a touching read as a young woman poet. I just found a lot of it really familiar to me and really relatable, so I did enjoy that one. The next one I picked up was We the Drowned by Carsten Jensen. In my second update, I was a little ways into it and I had a lot to say. In my third update, I had finished it and I really, really disliked it for many different reasons. I'll link all of my updates down below if you want more thoughts on all of these books that I read. I've got them all in the updates. I'll also link my Goodreads if you want to know what star rating I gave them. But this one I finished in the third update. Also in the third update, I had started A Little Life by Hanya Yanagihara. This is a recent publication, came out last year, and it is quite a mammoth. It follows 4 men who were best friends in college and then grew up in New York City together, and basically their lives up until about their 50s is when it goes up till. It was a really good read. Personally, I really enjoyed it. There's some pretty gruesome things, some pretty gross things, and it's generally just really heartbreaking, but I found it so well written. I think Hanya Yanagihara tells a story really, really well. I would compare her writing to the style of Donna Tartt in that she just weaves the story really effortlessly. I wouldn't recommend this book for the faint-hearted, and I wouldn't recommend it for people who don't like talk about abuse or mental health issues or suicide. I think that would get pretty difficult for you in this one. But overall, I did really enjoy it. I had a lot of friends who didn't, but I disagree. Since finishing off that one, I also picked up Salinger by David Shields and Shane Salerno. This is a biography of J.D. Salinger. I think this is the book that the film was based off, or this is the book version of the film. I'm not actually sure which one came first. This is also, as you can tell, quite a big book. It's also quite a tall book, which means even the pages are a little bit bigger than normal. I thought I was going to really struggle with this one, and it was probably the one I was least excited to pick up from the 5 that I chose, but it ended up being easily the fastest read out of all of them. I think I read it in about 2 weeks time. And the reason it was so easy is because it's written in verbatim style. So every paragraph is just a little excerpt from an interview that the writers did with people that knew J.D. Salinger, or excerpts from news articles or whatever else it was. And it just made it really, really quick to read. I found this stuff about his war experience pretty difficult because he went through some pretty horrific things, but also I found it incredibly interesting how creepy J.D. Salinger was. He used to kind of like stalk and seduce young women and have them come and live with him or start long distance relationships with him via letter. He did that pretty much up until his death. I had no idea that that was pretty much a well-known fact about him. I found that really creepy, but I really did enjoy it. I loved learning a lot more about an incredibly influential writer, and I just thought it was quite a good read. I would recommend this one. So while I did manage to finish 4 of the 5 books that I picked for this challenge, I didn't actually get to Carpentaria by Alexis, Wright. I finished Salinger maybe a week before the challenge finished, and I just didn't really pick up Carpentaria. I decided I wanted to try a few lighter things instead and finish a few shorter books instead of trying to get through this one in the time frame that I had left. I know this is a really dense, lyrical story about Indigenous Australians, and I just kind of wanted to give it a little bit more time and put myself in the right headspace for it. So didn't pick this up, didn't finish it. So there you go, that is how I went with my finish 5 by November 5th. Like I said, I will link down below all of the other women involved in this challenge. Please go and support them, watch their finales. I'm sure they all did really well. I'm very excited to go and watch them myself. I haven't quite gotten around to it yet, but I'm really excited to see how everyone did. I had a great time doing this. This is like the perfect melding of my love of beauty, my love of project panning, and my love of books, just in this really nice little mix collection here. So I really enjoyed this challenge, and while I wasn't 100% successful, I do think it was a successful challenge. If you participated, please let me know down below and I'll come and watch your finale. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. Have a great day. Bye!